So. Without comment. Yes, but it was another case, and it is a quite not similar, almost identical presentation. But it is more evident that this patient has a nodule. The other was not so evident that she had, and in fact, the previous patient had not a nodule. So this is the typical form of the starry sky phenomenon, and this patient had a papillary cancer. Most, if not all, of such presentations prove to be papillary cancer. And again, back to the previous consideration, it was not diffuse sclerotizing variant, but it was a multifocal papillary cancer. So here you can see the tumor core, and quite far from this tumor core, you can see areas showing having microcalcifications, and it proved to be a multifocal papillary cancer. So, if we try to analyze these one by one, then we could have some doubts whether could not these figures be backfall figures, but the entire pattern is absolutely clear. These are microcalcifications, and this is the starry sky phenomenon of this type of microcalcifications. And we should never forget one more problem which can cause concern, that papillary cancer tends to cystically degenerate. So tiny cystic areas are not the exception, but the rule in the event of papillary cancer. This is clearly clearly a solid nodule, but tiny cystic areas are frequently present in papillary cancer, so it adds one more problem to the differentiation of backwall figures and microcalcifications. But again, the ratio of granules to non-specific quite linear forms is very high in this case, so these are not backwall figures. Here, tiny cystic area, here another, okay, we can see, but the entire pattern, the whole pattern is very characteristic. And this nodule also had lobulated margins. It is very hard to find a good expression of such shape and border of nodules, so we cannot be fully sure where this nodule starts and where it ends. So it is an absolutely irregular presentation, but we have no words. A classical lobulated margin refers to those nodules which are clearly separated from the normal parenchyma, but it invades invasively this part of the thyroid. I don't know where it starts and where it ends. So, comments, questions related to this case? Next time somebody asked whether the nodule had signs of extratilar extension, it had signs of extratidal extension. We cannot diagnose extratidal extensions on ultrasound because a very low positive predictive value, but this is suspicious that it infiltrates the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and indeed this nodule proved to be minimally invasive, minimal extratidal extension. This nodule had minimal extratidal extension. Okay, other? If not, I present our last case.